So in the spiritual arena, love is not related to giving. Love is not related to getting. Love is not related to exchanging. Love is not related to measuring. Love is not related to keeping a list of tallies. And love does not represent something that gets evaluated. In the spiritual arena, love is related to something entirely different. If love isn't related to giving and love isn't related to getting, what's it actually related to? Being. Your desire for love, search for love, attempts at love, false trainings in love are because the true urge is love as being, to be love. Being love isn't calculating, isn't concerned with what do I get back. Being love is simply a quality of your being, a quality of how you walk and how you talk. It isn't, there's some love for him and for her, but none for him. It isn't selective. It doesn't say, this one deserves my love, this one's a total dud, forget it. No love for him, no love for her. It's a waste of my love. Love never calculates. Love naturally assumes the giving position, but not from a position of I want to give, I need to give. It assumes the giving position by definition in a stance of utter and total humility. Love doesn't seek to give itself. It appreciates when somebody's willing to take it. It feels grateful that you're willing to receive the love that's here, the love that's me, the love that can flow. It doesn't say, here, take this. It simply is. If somebody wants it, it's there for the taking. If somebody doesn't want it, no problem. Love doesn't evangelize. Love doesn't force. Love doesn't push itself at anybody. It's freely available. It's exactly like sunshine. When the sun is shining, the sun isn't saying, come here and have some sunshine. You want to sit inside with the windows closed and the shades drawn? The sun doesn't have any problem with that. Anyone who wants some sunshine, it's there. The sun is simply shining. That is the ancient most metaphor for love. Ancient most metaphor for God. The sun shining. It's the most correct. Because the sun isn't shining more on one than another, isn't shining more in one place than another place. It's simply shining. And whatever reaches, wherever it reaches. And whoever turns toward it, turns toward it. And whoever doesn't, the sun isn't bothered. Because the nature of the sun is to shine, is to give sunshine as a natural effect of being the sun. That's what I mean by love is related to being. When your being is love-based, then you're like a sun. Whoever comes to you, either they'll feel the love or they won't. That's on their side. It has nothing to do with you. You're not looking for opportunities to love someone. You're not looking for opportunities to deny love to someone. You're available at all times, in all ways. That's what love is. Love is not a loving feeling. Love is being completely available in all ways. Whatever is needed, love is happy to give it. If it can. If it can't, love isn't worried. So you've been taught that love is a commodity, like buying gasoline, like buying a pair of shoes. Love is not a commodity. Is sunshine a commodity? Can you go to the store and buy some extra sunshine on a cloudy day? Just like sunshine can't be and will never be a commodity, love will never be actually a commodity. That's all bogus. You've been sold a bill of goods that isn't true. The same as if you'd been taught, the same as if you'd been trained that sunshine can be bought and sold. So get rid of these false ideas, and then you've got a shot at knowing for yourself what divine love is, how divine love works, and get out of the business deal approach to life, which means sometimes you'll win. So in the business deal, there are winners and losers. But if there are winners and losers, by definition, and sometimes you win, guess what? You're also guaranteed sometimes to lose. The only way to never win and lose in the love game is be like the sun. Then you can't win and you can't lose. Has the sun ever lost by being full of sunshine? In fact, the sun is only in a win position.